I am sharing our three game changers that are making it possible for us to continue living on one income comfortably. It's a game changer. So I guess that's my secret game changer. Hey team, what's good? What's happening? I hope that you're tickety-boo. I'm Heather, and if you are brand new, hi, hello, and welcome. And if you're returning, what's good? What's happening? I hope that you're all tickety-boo, as I said, and that things in your world are going well, life is good, you've got plenty of crochet time. Currently, I'm on a break from HGDC, HG Designs Crochet. I made a decision almost 2 months ago to the day, today I believe, that I was going to take a step back from my own brand so that I could take some time to regroup, reprioritize, and figure out what direction I wanted to go in and make a load of changes that we felt as a family we needed to make and to install. And I made a whole video on taking that break, which I'll post up above. And in the lead up to choosing to take that break, I also recorded a load of vlogs. And in one of the vlogs, I touched upon our finances. So I will insert that clip now for you.
And on top of that, we've had like a big kick to our budget because Brad's car broke. My car's out off the road. We've had to pay out on some items that we didn't have a budget for, and it all just feels a lot right now. So, oh dear. It would help if I had some pattern sales and had a bit of my own money.
I am sharing our three game changers that are making it possible for us to continue living on one income comfortably. As a little bit of background context so that all of this video will then make sense to you, I had my son in 2022, and pre-pregnancy, I always assumed that I would have my child and then they would go into daycare or nursery and I would return to full or part-time work, and that would be a hybrid of using my qualifications. I am a qualified legal executive, so a solicitor or lawyer, depending on where, what area you are in the world, and a hybrid mix of HGDC as well, so that I would have multiple income streams and we would do what worked for our family in that season. I did go and visit a daycare setting and I was very happy with it, but I just knew in my heart that it was not the right timing for my son. It wasn't right for Teddy. I would just be purely doing it for me. Brad was very, very anti-daycare and he was very adamant that he wanted me to be a stay-at-home mum, and maybe I'll make a whole video on that. I don't know if any of you have got questions or if you've been in this situation, but I can definitely make a video on how that all came about. So because we made the choice that Teddy would not be going into daycare, we effectively made the choice that we'd be a one income family. And when we officially made that choice, made that decision, our finances changed. They changed overnight, in effect, because before that decision, we were always had the assumption that there would be more income coming in and that whatever situation we were in, we would rectify with that increase of income. And then when we made a decision that I would be staying home, we basically said we would be a one income family. Now, I do have an income from HGDC, but I'm discounting that for the time being because as I am self-employed, some months it could be a couple of pounds, some months it could be a couple of hundred, other months it could be up to the thousand point. It really depends on what's going on within my business. I have a whole heap of plans focusing on that, But for the point of this video and our finances, we discount HGDC. If anything comes in, it's a bonus, but we do not rely on it. And again, I've got a whole host of reasons for that as well. So we made that decision, and like for us, it was official from September 2023, because that was when his start date for nursery would have been. And from that point until the new year, so from September to the January, we went through a baptism of fire. We had, our budget was hit from all angles. We went through so many difficulties. Like, honestly, I feel that God just put us through the ringer for a few months to be like, this is what you have signed up for. You need to get yourself sorted. And in that clip I've just played you, that was me saying, I hear you loud and clear. We need to get this sorted out. And our finances had become such a huge stress on us. Fast forward to January 2024, and we knew we needed to make changes. We are very, very early on in this journey. I'm recording this in May. It's May the 11th. And we have officially been following these steps since, I'm going to say January, because that's when we truly realised we needed to get our stuff in gear. So this is month 5. These are the 3 top things that we have done to ensure that we can continue living comfortably on a one income, as a one income family. And I'm hoping that in sharing this, it might give you an insight yourself. Maybe this is something you want to do. Maybe it will help you in your own finances. This is an area, finances is an area that I spend a lot of my time. We spend a lot of our time going over this. And so I really want to share our journey and what we're learning along the way. And hopefully I can pick up some tips and advice from you as well. There are some very set stages in our timeline. So there is pre-decision. I'd say this is the decision, September 2024, that Teddy is staying home. We are staying home. So we've got pre-decision and post-decision. And pre-decision, our finances were hugely, hugely different. So I am married. My husband is called Brad. I don't know why I just did that. I am married. My husband, his name is Brad, and we have one son, Teddy, and he will be 2 next month. I've spoken to Brad about sharing these details, and he is a very private person. However, he's happy for me to share everything but the specific numbers of his income, and so I will honour that. I can still share plenty without needing to break down the exact figures that he's earning. Pre-decision and pre-Teddy, our finances were completely split. I moved into our family home. Brad purchased it basically he bought this property before he met me, and by the time it all finalized, he moved in when we were in the early stages of our relationship. So I in effect moved into a bachelor pad. He thankfully made some really smart financial decisions, which has really helped us in our current situation of being a one income family. That's just given me another video idea. Because this was Brad's home, he already had all of the income, the ins and outs covered. So when I moved in, there wasn't a financial need for me to contribute to the outgoings. Like, Brad already had it covered. However, I did contribute. So I, in effect, put a chunk in each month to cover the food bill and a couple of other bits and bobs. And then we generally went 50-50 on everything else, such as the any dates that we did, experiences, things like that, holidays. We generally went 50-50. Now, the reason I wasn't contributing more to the household finances is because I had made the decision I wanted to go full-time with HGDC. So Brad and I were in agreement that I would have like a grace period, so to speak, where I didn't need to think about the additional bills and whatnot. I could just focus on my income. And then once the plan was, once my income reached a certain threshold, that I would then start contributing more. And then pregnancy kicked in and everything changed for us. But we have always had our finances very separate, and we've always had similar goals, but we've always had our own money coming in. Then we make sure that the joint stuff's taken care of, and then we can do what we want with the rest of it. And now, post decision, Brad has the income coming in, and we need to have the same goals and the same decisions. So it has been a whole learning curve for the both of us. We've had to learn our own strengths and weaknesses within budgeting. Brad has strengths that I don't possess, and I have strengths that he doesn't possess. And we both have weaknesses that the other tries to counteract and keep an eye on. So after the way September to December 2023 treated us, we knew we needed to make some changes, because if we didn't, I would be forced to go and get a job of some sort just so that we had enough to get by, and that's not what we wanted. And Brad has such a generous income that we shouldn't need to do that anyway. I will also add that pre-pregnancy, I was very, very disciplined with my money. Because of the pandemic, I, like many others, felt very vulnerable, and so I saved up quite a chunk of money. I cleared off almost all of my debt, other than an interest-free credit card. I lived well below my means, and that's a huge factor that contributed to me being able to go full time with HGDC, because my outgoings were just so minimal. It was so easy to save up like 3 4 years worth of expenses and have no worries about that. And then pregnancy kicked in, and we went through so many horrors and so many stresses. And one of the unseen consequences of that, not only is that I didn't have any income and that we had a load of extra outgoings, but that our self-discipline vanished in terms of our finances. It was very much a case of buy it now and we'll deal with it later, because we were just in absolute survival mode, which means that we came through pregnancy and first year of having a newborn, and we made decisions with our finances that we wouldn't normally make. So we took on additional finance payments. All of my savings were gone because of not having an income for such a period of time. It was like 2 years in effect of just living off next to nothing and my savings. So I felt like we came into January a little bit groggy, a bit like, what has just happened? And we needed to face up to some of the choices we'd made. We did all of the usual things that you would expect to be told to do when you are when there's a change in your finances. So we made a budget, we started living below our means, we swapped to different providers to make savings in that way. We did all of the things we could do to our budget to make sure that we weren't overpaying, oversubscribed. Like, rather than have Netflix, Disney, Amazon, we got rid of them all, you know, that type of stuff, and just massively cut back where we could. So we did all of those things, and that's where we were in January. And we made the decision that in order to turn around our finances, we needed to pay off our debt and finance payment. The first major thing that we did, having done all of those little steps that, like the standard procedure that you would expect us to do, is we had to set our priorities. And this is the first thing that I recommend that you do. It was a game changer for us. So we sat down and we spoke about, what do we want from our finances now in this season? What do we want our finances to look like in 5 years, in 20 years, long term? What is our big picture goal? And that really helped us to understand each other and what we were working towards. So for a few examples, in this season, I don't want to work outside of our home. I want to stay home with Teddy. Teddy is to always be with either Brad or myself. We want him to have his different activities that he goes to. We want him to be well clothed, well looked after, all of those things that finances plays a part into. We want to be comfortable on one income. We want to make sure that we can have experiences as a family. We want all of our bills paid for, and we want to save and invest for our future. And the big goal is that we will be able to save and invest for our future, that we will be debt and mortgage free, that we will have saved for Teddy's future and any future children we might choose to have, that we would have financial security, safety, and freedom. That's like our main goals for us. And with those priorities set, we did go back over our budget and we were like, right, what in here doesn't align with what our goals are? And the biggest thing for us is that we rearranged our budget into categories. So that's my second tip, is categorize your budget. So we now use a zero-based budget, which means that every single pound and penny is assigned. We know exactly where it's going every single month. And that way we know how much we have to contribute to all the different things we're working towards. And we then categorized our budget. So we had my outgoings, my personal outgoings, Brad's personal outgoings. We had everything for our home. We had everything for Teddy, and then we had our debt payments. And when you see all of that in a chunk and you see the total, that for us was a big game changer. So we count debt as anything that we have to pay monthly towards, or anything that is on finance. And it's not to say that we're anti-finance. We are anti-finance. I understand why people use it. We are in that same situation. We have used it, but we do not want to do that going forward. We want to have the freedom to use our money for what we want, not to pay off what we've previously decided to buy. And when we saw that in that category, we're paying like over £500 a month toward, I think at the start of the year, we had five different things. So I had a very small loan. I had my credit card. I had, and I'm just going to add, they were from pregnancy. Don't know why I feel like I need to justify that, but that was because of the way our pregnancy was. Then we had our TV. Again, a choice that Brad probably wouldn't choose to do, knowing we were going to be on one income. But these are the choices we made before we knew that. Then we have Brad's car, our family car, and we have some work that we did on our garden. So if we could go back, we wouldn't take on any of those payments. However, we can't go back. All we can do is deal with them now. So when you add that up, that's £500 a month. To put that into context, for us, that is the same amount as our food bill every single month. So if we can free up that money, that makes a big, big difference to our budget. And that's the difference between me needing to go get a part-time job and me being able to stay home super comfortably. So we made a decision at the start of the year that that our main priority was to be debt-free, and our budget, categorizing our budget, helped us to see that. So categorize your budget, set your priorities, and make sure that both of them are on the same page. I just had another video idea. So we use a spreadsheet to track our budget. So comment below if you'd like to see the spreadsheet, or if you'd like a link to purchase one for yourself, because it honestly has been a game changer. And we track each month. We can see the whole year. We can see exactly what's coming in, what's going out, where all of our money is supposed to be. Now, the next game-changing thing that we did, and I have notes down here. I have so many notes. The third game changer for us was to save for the future. This one, I think a lot of you might be with me on this one. Let me explain. So for example, every year, Christmas is on the same day of the year, every single year. And every year we would get to Christmas, not every year, but definitely last year, we got to Christmas. And we were like, we have no money set aside for Christmas. Everything that we need, food, gifts, experiences, the whole lot, needs to come from the December pay packet. And then you need to make all of December's pay not only cover the 5 weeks of December, all of the gifts, all of the food, all of the experiences for the festive period, but on top of that, it needs to also cover a few weeks into January because payday is delayed for whatever reason. And that really, really bit us last year, and it was painful. And it meant that some of the things that we might have chose to do, we couldn't do. And it just wasn't a pleasant place to be in, and we don't want to be in that place. And I said in my previous video, like, I don't want to find myself in this place a year from now. No, 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 no.
I don't want to find myself in this place this time next year. Like, no, 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 no.
So one of the massive game changers we have made is that every single month we contribute towards these future expenses. So, for example, for Christmas, we put £20 in a pot every single month. So that when Christmas rolls around, there's going to be 240 quid there. And that means that we can get some of the nicer bits for our food. And it means that we can, for our Christmas meal, it means that we can get the gifts that we want to get Teddy for Christmas. It means that, like, that money is there and we won't be in the position that we were in last year. We also save set money for car maintenance. So each month we put aside, I think we're currently putting in £75 a month, and that's to cover the car insurance, car tax, car service, and then any, there's like a little bit extra in there, which is then a buffer in case the car needs any work doing to it. Because every year these payments come round, and every year they take us by surprise, like, oh, I need to cover that. And then if you don't have that money, you end up putting it into a credit card, or you get a loan, or you pay it on monthly and it costs you more. So we are actively working towards that. This is something that I did do before I was pregnant, and so it's something that we have returned to slash stuck to, now sticking to as a family. And that has made a big difference because Brad's car insurance, his tax and his MOT are all due next month, as well as it being Teddy's birthday. And that means it would be a really, really expensive month. However, we've already put money aside for Teddy's birthday. We've already put money aside for the car. So we don't need to worry about that. And we will continue to do that throughout the year. So we will add to our gift pot and we will add to the car pot every single month. And that way we know we're covered. We are using Monzo as our banking app. And I will leave my referral link below. And I'll leave Brad's as well. I'm not sure if there's a limit on how many referrals we can have. I'm not sponsored in any way, but these are things that have really helped us. Within Monzo, when you log in, it shows you the different pots that you have set up, and you can set up as many as you want. So within mine, I have Teddy, Vinted, different savings goals, different things in there, and then I can set aside that money. So I know that if I need some new clothes, I can go to my Vinted balance. I think there's like 40 quid in there at the moment, and I can use that towards whatever item I want. And that has really helped us to stay super organized with our money, because prior to that, we had like a chunk of money in a savings account. And then you're trying to track on a spreadsheet or trying to keep a list on your phone of where this money was designated for. And then Brad had Santander and he had like 20 different savings accounts set up, and it just was clunky and it wasn't working. But Monzo worked really, really well. And I also have Starling, and I'll link that below, and I use that for HGDC's business account. And again, it has the pot set up, so I can save for my tax, I can save for yarn, I can save for the collection, I can save for my next planner drop. Like, it's all there. Honestly, such a game changer, and I can't recommend it enough. Save for your future expenses and have these pots set out so you know where you are. And those pots should then correlate with your spreadsheet. And the final game changer, it's a bonus. I know I said three, but I'm going to go with four. The fourth game changer that has made a big difference for our finances is cashback apps. So we have done the most to reduce our outgoings, to stretch our budget, And now it's about making our money work for us in terms of savings, in terms of interest, in terms of cashback. So if you can get reward points or anything like that for anywhere that you usually spend, then do it. If you can use that towards your fuel cost, whatever it is, do it. If you can save up the codes on the Pampers nappies and get free packs, do it. Like, all of these things mean that your money goes that much further, and it does really help out when you think, we need a new pack of nappies. And Pampers nappies are not cheap. Like, if you buy them full price, you're looking at like 20 quid if there's no deals on. But if you have a code or you see a deal and you capitalize on that, it means that you can get two or three packs for that same price. It makes a big difference. And so one of the new cashback apps that we have just started to use and we're just trying out is called Sprive. It's Sprive. And this is a cashback app where when you make your day-to-day normal purchases, so groceries, food shopping, anything for your home, home improvement, anything like that, travel, whatever it is, you use it, you purchase via the Sprive app, and then you receive cashback. So basically, we do our food shop at Asda, and using the Sprive app, we get something like 3% back. So for every £100 spent, we get £3 back. Is that right? 3% of 100. Yes, £3. So, okay, yeah, £3, no big deal. Is there any point? Yes, yes, there is, because you're going to be spending that money anyway, but they're giving you it back. So for every £100, you spent 97 and you get £3 to put in a pot. And we were using a cashback credit card. Side note, I'm going to caution against them because it is still debt. You might be paying it off each month, but it's still debt. So we have moved away from a cashback credit card, and instead we are now using Sprive. And for when all of the money accumulates, they make an overpayment towards your mortgage, which for us is a long-term goal. So to start now would make a huge, huge difference. And you can go on the dashboard and it shows you, like, say for example, you're going to be running about £500 a month through this app. It shows you how much that is going to make in terms of overpayments towards your mortgage. And then when you start, it also shows you how many years that will take off your mortgage payment. So if you think you're doing nothing different other than spending your day-to-day money, but it's going to reduce your mortgage, that's a huge game changer. So as I said, we've only just downloaded this. We've only just started using it. I will put our referral link below in case you want to sign up for it. I think you get £5 towards your mortgage for using the referral link. So take the fiver and overpay your mortgage. And then I think for us, we need three people to sign up for us to receive £25 back in overpayment. So 100% recommend. It is early days, and I will do I will review that app in a few months' time. I might even do like our first month on Sprive and see how that stacks up. Everything I've seen from the influencers I follow, from just having a look around the app, it's a game changer. So I guess that's my secret game changer. So yes, that is my four game changers for living on one income comfortably. I hope it's helped. Is there anything in there that you're going to go and check out? Let me know in the comments below. And is there anything that you would like to advise is, like, what are your game changers? I'd really like to know, and I'd like to know what your thoughts are on this type of video, because I have covered finances a little bit in the past, but not so much our personal finances. But as I said, it's such a huge part of our life, huge part of our lifestyle, living on one income and then also being self-employed, and I want to talk about more of that. It's something I'm always searching for and always want to talk about, so I just decided to talk about it ourselves. So yeah, thank you so much for joining me on this video, and I'll see you in the next one. Take care. Hey Team YouTube, how are you? Feels very weird to be doing this. Ooh. I think I need some water, I need a little bit of lip gloss, and then I shall be back. Hands up if your baby was awake for 3 hours in the morning. Well, a little bit of spray. Just make yourself your life easy and take these off now, please. Okay, let's try again. Ooh. I always look at myself and think, I look such a state, I can't possibly put this on the internet. And then I put it up and I look back, like, say 3 months later, I look back and I'm like, actually, I was looking all right then. I wish I looked like that now, because now I look even worse. So yeah, maybe just practice a bit of self-kindness. Hello, team. Oh, I feel so awkward. I might just record the intro at the end, because by then I'll have warmed up. The intro is always the hardest bit. Okay. This one's done.